Aldo, for you, you know, you've spent the longest part of your career in business, so you would see those new CAs coming in applying for the roles. How do you then in the business assess the commercial experience, or what do you look for?
It's an interesting question, because people with experience don't necessarily have the skill set you're looking for to achieve or to complete a role or to meet the requirements of a role. So what we look for is a lot of the time the intuitiveness and the actual character behind a person and what they actually do in their role. So if they can demonstrate, you know, attributes of understanding their client's business and asking the right questions around what that business actually does and what it means and how things work, sometimes that's worth a lot more than someone who's had 3 or 4 years experience in a particular part of a business, say supply chain or distribution, who has really just gone through the motions day after day and doesn't really understand what the business is doing, hasn't had that experience to ask those questions. So really ask the right questions and learn what those questions are. And that's a skill in itself, is actually learning what questions to ask and learning what parts of a business you need to understand.
I might pause there for a minute and just see, are there any questions from the floor at this point?
Hi. What is it about being a CA with professional services experience and a strong financial background that would give me the advantage or edge in a position if I'm trying to get to that commercial operational level role?
Generally with the commercial roles, especially within CCA, you need to have a fairly good understanding of how the business works operationally to be able to add value at the levels that are expected in analyst type roles or commercial type roles. So typically you would, working through a financial accounting type role, learn a lot of the nuts and bolts and the baseline of the business to then be able to get you into the mode of adding value in a commercial or commercial aspect. However, that being said, if you've got the ability to look at a business and understand the numbers, understand the impacts and the drivers between different business units and different areas, really hone in on, you know, the key things that drive a business, nothing saying you can't move straight into a commercial role.
One last question from somebody up the front here.
Just wondering, when you said when you went into financial accounting, that was the only backward step of your career. Can you just like elaborate a bit on
that? Yeah, no, happy to. It was most of my peers that actually said, well, you're moving to financial accounting, why? Why would you ever move to financial accounting if you've been in commerce and you do all the sexy stuff? 3 years later in that role is probably one of the most valuable experiences I've had in my life in terms of actually understanding the size of a business at CCA and working through each of the different sub-ledger teams and working through all the different aspects and exposures that we were privy to. If you ever want to be a CFO or a CEO or move into a really high level area, you really need to understand both commercial and financial aspects of a business to be able to cover all your risks and exposures. So it was immensely rewarding experience. So it seemed backwards from my peer group, but now I'd suggest anyone that has worked in commerce for a while, do financial accounting, because you'll understand a business from a completely different angle.